हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ अनीशा शर्मा, इंटर्न एट लेक्स क्लिक एंड कंपनी। ऑल्सो आई एम अ फोर्थ ईयर स्टूडेंट एट मोती यूनिवर्सिटी। दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर ऑल द वुमेन्स दैट आर वर्किंग एंड आर लाइकली टू कंसीव। सो इन केस यू आर लुकिंग फॉर मेटर्निटी बेनिफिट दैट यू विल बी एंटाइटल्ड, दिस वीडियो वुड बी फॉर ऑल द वुमेन्स। सो द मेन टॉपिक दैट आई विल बी कवरिंग अंडर द वीडियो वुड बी व्हाट इज़ द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द मेटर्निटी बेनिफिट एक्ट 1961, the cash benefits that a woman would be entitled in case she is conceiving, also the non-cash benefits or the privileges that she'd be entitled to. We'll be also discussing the Maternity Benefit Act 2017, its applicability and eligibility for the act. And this video would contain a broad overview of the act, not the act in total. Talking about the objective of the Maternity Benefit Act 1961, the act is to protect the dignity of motherhood and the dignity of the newborn life that is coming into the world, and it provides for a full and healthy maintenance of the woman and the child even when she is not working. Talking about the cash benefits that the woman would be entitled to, she would be entitled to a leave with average pay for 6 weeks before her delivery. Also, an average pay for 6 weeks after the delivery, which has been increased to 8 weeks by the Amendment Act of 2017, which we'll be discussing later on. Also, she'd be entitled to a medical bonus of 25 rupees if the employer does not provide free medical care to the woman. This was in 1961's Act. Also, an additional leave with pay to 1 month if the woman gives proof that she is ill due to either the pregnancy or the delivery or the miscarriage or the premature baby. In case there is a miscarriage, a 6 week leave with average pay from the date of miscarriage would be allowed to the woman. Talking about the non-cash benefits or the privileges, she'd be entitled to light work for 10 weeks before the date of expected delivery if she asks for it. For this right, she has to ask the employer to provide her with to allot her with work that is of less labor or less light weight. Also, she'd be entitled to 2 nursing breaks until the baby is 15 months old. Also, the employer cannot dismiss or discharge the woman while she is on her maternity leave. So the employer cannot escape from this liability of providing her with the average pay by terminating the woman. Also, she cannot be demoted during this period. The employer cannot lower her average pay by giving her a lower rank or a lower position in which she was while she was on the maternity leave. Also, she cannot be discharged or any disadvantage that is and according to the conditions of her employment that cannot be lowered. But there is an exception for this. In case the woman conducts any gross negligence or any gross misconduct, if there is any gross misconduct on the part of the woman, then the employer would be entitled to remove the woman from the job without giving her this maternity benefits. Talking about the Maternity Benefit Act 2017, this act was the bill that was passed in Lok Sabha was on 9th March 2017, and in Rajya Sabha it was passed on 11th August 2016. The bill has received the assent of the President on 27th March 2017. It came into effect, the bill that came into effect, it was on 1st April 2017. However, the provisions related to the crèche facility that has been provided under the Act would that has been provided under Section 11A, to be more specific on the Act, that came into effect on 1st July 2017. Talking about the applicability of the Act would be applicable to all establishments, factories, mines, plantations and all government establishments. The eligibility criteria for a woman under the Act is that she should work for at least 80 days before, in the past 12 months before she has applied for this maternity benefit. And the changes that was there, the changes, the amendments in the leave that has been provided under the 2017 Act was that the paid maternity leave has been increased to 26 weeks and the leave prior to the expected delivery date is 18 weeks. Thank you.